Pulmonary diffusion refers to the process by which oxygen from the air we breathe diffuses from the lungs into the bloodstream, and carbon dioxide, a waste product of cellular metabolism, diffuses from the bloodstream into the lungs to be expelled from the body. This vital exchange of gases occurs at the alveolar capillary interface in the lungs, and it is essential for sustaining life. This video covers the medical definition and provides a brief overview of this topic. So if you're ready, let's get into it. As previously mentioned, the respiratory system is designed to optimize the exchange of gases. The lungs contain millions of small sac-like structures called alveoli, which provide an enormous surface area for gas exchange to occur. These alveoli are surrounded by a rich network of capillaries, the smallest blood vessels in the body. The walls of the alveoli and capillaries are extremely thin, allowing gases to move across them rapidly. When you take a breath in, air from the environment that is rich in oxygen enters the lungs and travels into the alveoli. Simultaneously, blood flowing through the surrounding capillaries carries carbon dioxide, produced as a waste product from cellular processes. Through a mechanism called passive diffusion, oxygen in the alveoli moves down its concentration gradient into the blood, while carbon dioxide in the blood moves down its concentration gradient into the alveoli. This ensures that the body receives oxygen for metabolic processes and gets rid of the carbon dioxide. There are certain factors that can influence pulmonary diffusion, including the following. The first is surface area. Any factor that reduces the available surface area of the alveoli can impair pulmonary diffusion. Conditions like emphysema, where the walls of the alveoli are damaged, can significantly reduce the surface area. Next is diffusion distance. Gas exchange is most efficient when the distance between the alveoli and the capillaries is minimal. Any thickening of the alveolar or capillary walls, as seen in conditions like pulmonary edema or interstitial lung diseases, can impede the diffusion process. Another factor is the pressure gradient. The difference in partial pressures of gases, especially oxygen and carbon dioxide, between the alveoli and the blood plays a significant role in the diffusion process. If the pressure gradient is high, diffusion occurs more rapidly. And you also have to factor in the solubility and molecular weight of gases. Some gases diffuse more easily than others due to differences in solubility and molecular weight. For instance, carbon dioxide is more soluble and has a lower molecular weight compared to oxygen, making it diffuse about 20 times faster than oxygen. However, since the primary function of the lungs is to oxygenate the blood, a much larger difference in partial pressure for oxygen is maintained to ensure its efficient diffusion. But as I said before, the efficiency of pulmonary diffusion is crucial for our overall health. Conditions that compromise this efficiency can lead to a drop in blood oxygen levels, resulting in symptoms like shortness of breath, fatigue, and cyanosis. This process ensures that our body's tissues receive the oxygen they need for energy production and that waste products are efficiently removed. As a medical professional, understanding and monitoring pulmonary diffusion is essential in the diagnosis and management of various respiratory conditions. If you want to support the channel, please like and subscribe. I would greatly appreciate it. There should be some other helpful videos popping up on your screen right about now that I think you will enjoy. And just a quick reminder, we are not doctors. This video is for informational purposes only. Thank you so much for watching. Have a blessed day, and as always, breathe easy, my friend.